now, baby, now. You see, it's a fleeting place. But you've been programmed to think one way, and God has already prepared it. God set the order for you. But you're so busy doing what Pookie and them did, Mama them did, and all the rest of them did. But God says, I got you. Do what I tell you to do. And I said, what happened is, so whatever, they call you bougies. Wait at it one more time. All singly repeat after me. Say, I'm not bougie. I'm just selected. Watch this. But you can't be selected. You can't be selected until you master your feelings first. Because if you don't master your feelings, the first one come along that look like what you asked God for, you gonna start drooling at you. And get caught up in the physical. I thought he was coming down. And if he get that, come he get that. Verse 11, he said, and in 11 verse, the writer goes on to say this. I'm really almost. And it came to pass. Man of God, you might want to sit over there, man of God. I feel anointed. I felt anointed calling. Okay, I was just joking a little bit, but sit over there anyway. If the Holy Ghost hits you, just I won't do what you do. But don't be pushing me over there, man. Just in case, I mean, I need, just in case you let me do a little something, be ready, don't get ready. Let me talk to the musicians, the drummers and all of them. Put a drum. See, now you didn't see him, I did. See, sometimes the drummer can't be here, so God got to have a reserve. And y'all can't see him sitting there. Somebody get this thing in a minute. We walk by faith and not by sight. If when y'all stop looking at what you see, you'll start seeing what you're looking at. Your vision is a bit off, so you see different than I see. The church may be half empty, I see it overflowing. Because that little bit of tongue controls a whole lot. It controls everything that come out of your mouth, and it's powerful. And so you can kill, destroy, or cause life with that tongue. And so the problem is you keep looking at what's not, instead of believing God for what's going to be, or what is. And so change what you've been looking at, change what you've been getting. Can I put somebody to prove a vision? Over in Jeremiah, the first chapter, he was talking to Jeremiah, and first thing he did, Jeremiah, he put his word in Jeremiah's mouth. How I know, because he said it was like fire shut up in him. He put his word in his mouth. Then he asked the person, what you see, son? He said, I see the rod of an almond tree. God told him, you've seen well, son. And because you've seen it, I'm going to perform it. What did he see? What God put in him. See, you keep seeing what you got in you, but you ain't seeing what God put in you. Because you're used to doing you. You're used to being natural. But when you got saved, you changed. Oh, I'm sorry. You were supposed to change. And so what happened is, you don't realize. So we get in the habit, Pastor. We get in the habit of saying things we used to say. So we get what we used to get. We call it insanity. Doing the same thing, thinking some different. It's insanity, and that's what we've been doing. So now you got to change how you've been thinking. How many of y'all take medicine? Look what you do. How many of y'all talk to that medicine before you put it in your mouth? Don't lie to me. So you know the last person that lies to the Holy Ghost. Drop it in. So if you lie to me, you lie to the Holy Ghost. I like to prove things, that's Peter. Peter asked, I'm not a survivor, what you do money? They lied to Peter, didn't they? No, they lied to the Holy Ghost. Because Peter was sent by God. See, that's what we don't get it. So when you be lying, tell the pastor why you didn't come, you know you were lying. You ain't lying to her, you lying to the Holy Ghost. I'm trying to help you understand some things. We done got out of place with this mess, and we think that we're getting over. You ain't getting over God, see what we doing? Fix it before it's too late. And it came to pass when Moses held up his hand that Israel prevailed. And when he let down his hand, then I let prevail. Come on, Harry, to her. What did you go? You working on it. Come on, D, come on up here. Somebody say, I promise you, he almost through. Tell your neighbor, I promise he almost through. Somebody say, paint, Bishop, paint. In that 11th verse, let me read it one time for you. And it came to pass, hold your hands up, Pastor Simon. Yeah, hold your arms right here. when Pastor Samuel held up her hands, that Israel, stand up Israel, Joshua, that's you. Both of you, you Joshua. Yeah, y'all one. You know, y'all one, so I make sure y'all both Joshua. In the fifth chapter of Genesis, God made a male and female, and he called them Adam. He called them Adam. So, y'all Joshua. And so, that's the battle. They doing the battle, and watch this thing, y'all. It's going to be pretty when God get through with it. And it came to battle when Moses held up her hand, and then Israel prevailed. And when she let down her hands, Amalek prevailed. Say Adam, Joshua. This is the way the battle went. Up and down, up and down, up and down. Something's wrong is going on in the camp today. Something is bad in the camp today. The wrong Moses is trying to take over the camp. The wrong Moses is trying to run the church. You got some folk in the pew trying to tell the pastor through their friend how it ought to be ran. They won't go to the pastor, but they'll say, what she needs to do it this way. So they sit back in the back of the church and begin to dialogue how the church ought to be ran. They begin to put together a blueprint, an architectural blueprint of what needs to take place. And the reason why the ministry ain't going because we ain't got this and we ain't got that. And all the time, though, amen, Joshua, stand up, Joshua, is going to battle, amen. And most of the time they win and it goes, come on, raise them up. Because she got her hands in her position. But something happened along the way. Glory to God. I come to help the camp. Can I help you there real quick? Glory to God. Come on, grab my reader, reader. Watch this thing here, y'all. Paul, y'all, Moses' arms got heavy. He couldn't do it with it. He got tired. Read on. And they took a stone and set it up under Moses. Watch this thing, y'all. Beautiful thing I've ever seen. Imagine a chair being a stone. They put a stone up under Moses. And put it under him, watch his thing, where he can sit down and be comfortable while he was raising up his hands. Come on. And he sat there on it, watch his feet. And Aaron and her. But what were they doing then? Stayed up the arm underneath there. Hold it up like that, brother. Hold it, there you go. They held up the arms. You know what happens when you take your hand, and if I hold these feet rocks for about 45 minutes, if I can make it that long, and arm begin to get heavy. After a while, I can't hold it up no more. So I need a few Abrams and a few hers that'll come along and hold me steady. That'll put their arms upon the read on, daughter. One on the one side. And the other on the other side. And her arms were steady. Wait a minute. If the enemy comes in and try to push it down, it can't move because she got it steady by old Abram. She got it steady by old her. And it won't move, y'all. Read. And I'm telling you, all day long, they held her up until the break of evening. Holy Ghost, watch this thing, y'all. And after a while, where my Joshua was at? Come on out here, Joshua. While they were holding up Moses' arms and fighting the thing, here come Joshua. Hallelujah, face that way. They were doing their thing. And all of a sudden, y'all, at the end of the day, restored. Here's what happened. Read, daughter. Go ahead on.
Aaron had their hands up.
Yeah.
And Joshua had his hands up.
People, it looked like y'all. Moses had her hands up. Aaron and her had their hands under. Joshua had his hands on. Can I say that again, y'all? Moses had his hands up. Aaron and her had their hands under. And Joshua hands on. Somebody got to run this thing, and it's got to be to Moses. Somebody got to help Moses out. It's got to be Aaron and her. And somebody got to be Joshua. While she was holding up the staff, Joshua was fighting the battle. The Bible tells me they fought the battle of Jericho. Wait 1 minute, y'all. The Bible said, here's what they did. Get behind it. They had a choir. Come on, sisters, on the end. Come on, Jones, sisters, y'all tune in. They had a choir. Somebody say hallelujah. They got in line. And watch what the priest told them. Stand in front of me. We're going to march around Jericho for 7 days. But you're going to lead the way. I said, wait a minute, Lord. These beautiful young ladies, you're going to put them on the front end of the line to do battle. But I seen God in action. He said, hold on, son. I got a plan. I know. Watch this thing, y'all. 7 days, we gonna march around this thing. Go on marching. And they begin to look right behind the finger. They begin to march around Jericho. Somebody shout one. Somebody shout two. Somebody shout three. Somebody shout four. Somebody shout five. Somebody shout six. Somebody shout seven. Wait a minute. The priest told him, on the seventh day, we gonna march around seven times. And on the seventh time, we gonna shout. Let's march on. Somebody shout three. Somebody shout four. Somebody shout five. Somebody shout six. Somebody shout seven. Now they begin to shout, Satan. And they begin to praise him. The worshipers begin to praise. On the Bible said, the songwriter said, Joshua fought the battle of Jericho. Of Jericho, and the wall fell down flat. But I got news for you. Joshua led the battle, but he didn't fight the battle. It was the praise team. It was the worshipers. I'm trying to help you out here. I double dare you, when you come in this house, get your worship on. I dare you, when you come in this house, get your praise on. Joshua wanted to work so hard. Moses wanted to give instructions. You'll come in running. I come to tell you the reason why God blessed this man and woman of God. Because they always got a Joshua spirit. And they're worthy of the labor. They're worthy of the honor. Double honor. Because they do what they Moses say to do. I'm telling you, Joshua would go stand at the peak, the bottom of the mountain, while Moses go up beyond. He will stay there until Moses come down. Here's what we do. We get at the base of the mountain. Ooh, Lord, I'm tired, I'm tired, I'm tired. And we find us a stone there. And we sit down by the brook. Yes, we do. They made a song about it. And they sit there until they see Moses coming down. And they jump up and act like they're ready. But Joshua stayed there all day long. Stayed there all night long. Moses told Joshua, go back to the camp. But Joshua said, no, I'm going to stay right here. I'm not going to move. I'm telling you all, Brother Chris and Sister Teresa, God's preparing you to take over Moses' place. It may be a while. Hold on. Hold on. If you think for one moment, Pastor Sandler is entrusting you to do what you do because you don't trust you. You're fooling yourself. He's preparing you. Because after a while, it's coming your way. I see Moses all yonder with the old hard neck, rubber neck, broke down, busted, disgusted people crying over here, crying over there. Moses, you done got us out in this wilderness, and we ain't gonna make it. But I come to tell you, Moses said, stand still and see the salvation of God. We thirsty, Moses. We thirsty. Moses got angry, and she hit the rock. But God told Moses to speak to it. What you saying, Bishop? One day, we all gonna be a Moses. You might not hit a rock, but your time will be up. But God needs to leave a legacy somewhere. But he got a Joshua at the base of the church. Hallelujah. So one day, it may be Elder, it may be somebody else, but she's gonna pass the torch. And I declare and decree, if I'm gonna pass my torch, it's gonna be somebody found faithful to doing what I need done. I don't know about you, but I'm so glad. I'm honored even to be here today to honor my brother and sister for their laboring. Because after a while, God's gonna say, well done, thou good and faithful servant. You've been faithful over a few things. Come on up. Come on, Lord, praise the Lord. Come on, give a lot of praise. Come on, come on, somebody shout hallelujah. Joshua. So you can lie to me, but you can't lie to your Moses. It's time, saints. Most of us are used to, give me some salt, we're used to going to church. Don't let it be two services. How many of y'all ain't got one service? I've been preaching for 30 years. I've never been able to eat if I have to preach two services. You can eat my favorite food, cheese. I love cheese. You know, it's strange, some of y'all, I love the cheese over everything. And it doesn't bother me a little bit. I refuse to come before God's people. Unprepared. I didn't come here to please anybody. I came to celebrate my big brother and my sister. Over 20 plus years we've been friends. I ain't seen him at least over 15, I don't know how many long, I don't know. But it was like just like yesterday when I saw him. I keep a picture of the girls on my wall. That's what y'all know. Well, in the church it was in, it was on my wall in my office. Then I'm going to put it on my wall. If you really understood the impact you had over my life. Over there, back then, over there they grew. And they were great. Incredible. I knew it was something like magnificent. It was incredible to work. And I remember when they first came down and I was at awe. Because I didn't just see some beautiful young ladies just in ministry. They were really incredible. And it was sincere. The tears you saw flowing, they were crying then. It's okay to cry. It's okay to be emotional. But it has its place. God's trying to set you up for a blessing. But you keep getting in the way of yourself. Some of us are using too much tradition. I'm not knocking churches. I'm knocking people. I don't care if you go through a Holy Ghost field, sanctified, chakra, speaking in tongues, you know, apostolic, all that, it don't matter to me. Your lifestyle tells me who you are. I've walked through this whole house, I can tell you all your business, right? Every one of you. See, I don't want to get you ready to be here. Don't test God. He's just selected who he deals with. Some of y'all, stop running saying you got a word for me. Because you really don't want that word they really got for you. They're really trying to spare you. When y'all look at Pastor Sanders, some of you look at her, you say, Mother getting old. She's rich. She's not old. If you had an ounce of the wisdom she got, it'll blow your mind. How many of y'all belong to this ministry? Raise your hand. I know it's a lot of guest church. No, we're going to be ashamed about it. We got about 25, we small. But we huge. Because we're anointed. Because we're real. Give me 10 real folk, you can have 1,000 folk. Because when I call on 10, they come. In Corsicana, Texas, on my way to see the Cowboys play, me and my wife, stop at a store and realize we left the tickets at home. I posted it on Facebook. Yeah, I'm going to go there. Stand up, daughter. My spiritual daughter, Lady Jackie, called me. Said, Bishop, where are you? Cross County. Meet me in Madisonville at Buckets. You know, I like Buckets. She went by my house. My other daughter let her in. Gave her a ticket. She drove from Houston to Madisonville to meet us with the tickets. Her and her baby. I'm not telling you I'm all that. But she loved me enough to do that. And so what Pastor Sandy is saying, she loved him enough to do this. And I want to challenge every one of you, wherever you serve, whether you're pastor here or not, they're longing for you to do the same thing. Their age doesn't matter. They just want to know that you're giving God your all. We can work with a few people if you give it God your all. Stand up, IGBM. I told them less than a week we're going to Bryan. And more would have came had they not been sick. So I want to give them some flowers for pressing their way. Thank you. I said, God, I don't want to have to go down there in 15 cars. He said, we'll get you a van and sell that thing. I said, Lord, it's going to be expensive. I paid $47 for the van to bring us from Houston. The favor of God. She tried to get me, well, you might want to purchase some extra miles. I said, no, already I'm putting it on the clock. It's 106 miles from here to Bryan. That's 212 going back. That's 20 more miles to go out my way a little bit. We'll be all right. Well, sometimes they won't take your insurance. God got us. All I'm saying to you is this. What are you willing to do to get what you need? How far are you willing to go? How far are you willing to go? Now look at this ministry. New Testament now. Number two. And number one, okay, number two is somewhere, right? I think I saw two. Maybe God. You started, okay, what it is. This is, when I saw the building, I got excited. God used me, some of the greatest work he used me in buildings like this. They ain't top fancy, you know, all the cathedral type stuff. The Holy Ghost up in here. Now, obviously, these mighty men behind me ain't got no problem with you being a pastor, because they up in here. But y'all do know what's out here. Tell you, God ain't started a woman to preach that don't pastor. But they hold my man. They're paying beautiful young ladies to sit on the front row with nothing. Y'all know where I'm going with that. Distracting the man of God. Yeah, that's gonna distract him. I'm closing with this. I was in a revival in Victoria, Texas. 15 pastors behind me. Just sit there. They have, remember that short prayer, I'm gonna sit right side. And ask her to go home if you don't mind. And then put